viewers all over the world. I greet you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. I humbly request you to listen to the message of God. Shall we pray? Our dear Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we ask thee to bless the reading and the hearing of this word.
Amen.
Amen. Shall we read together from the book of Acts, chapter 3, verse 4 to
8?
Peter and John looked at him intently.
Petro na Johanna bangu languta shinene bangu honolela.
And Peter said,
Kutani Petro aku.
Look at us.
Hilangutise.
The lame man looked at them eagerly.
Kutani wanuna lua washigona awa langutisa shinene.
Expecting to get some money. But Peter said,
Kutani Petro aku.
I don't have any silver or gold for you.
Aku silver shona.
But I will give you what I have.
Mara nita shona.
In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Christ wa Nazareta.
Get up and walk.
Suka uima ufamba.
Then Peter took the lame man by right hand.
Kutani Petro aku.
And helped him up. And as he did, the man's feet and ankles were instantly healed. And strengthened. He jumped up. Stood on his feet. And began to walk. Then walking and leaping. And praising God. And went into the temple with them. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
This brings us to the topic, enough is enough. The Bible says Simon Peter and John went to the temple in the evening.
Simon Peter na Johanna aba kongoma entepeleni na madambu.
They went to pray. The Bible says at the gate of the temple of Solomon there was a man who was sitting there. This man was born crippled. That was not an enjoyable situation. That was the most difficult situation. That was the situation of the background of limitation. When it comes to the crippledness, there are two types of the crippledness. There are those who are born crippled like this man. And there are those who are crippled by other people. There are people who are born right but crippled by other people.
There
are people who are born genius but crippled by the other people. There are people who are born wise but crippled by other people. There are people who are born great but crippled by other people. There are people who are born called by God but crippled by other people. There are people who are born champion but crippled by the other people. There are people who are born success but crippled by other people. Without any shadow of doubt, much as Jeremiah was born called by God, Born blessed by God. You are one of the people who are born wise. You are one of the people who are brought in this world. You are brought and born great. You are one of the people who are born a champion. You are one of the people who are born success. You are one of the people who are born victorious. Now I want to tell you, if there is somebody somewhere who is trying to cripple your life, in the name of Jesus, it shall not work. Because I know there are people who try to cripple other people's lives. Remember the issue of Joseph. In the book of Genesis chapter 37 verse
8.
After Joseph told his dreams to his brothers. He said, I saw the 12 bundles well bowing down. But my bundle was standing up. They say, who are you? Do you think you will become our king? Do you think you will rule over us? They were trying to cripple his vision. They were trying to cripple his dream. They were trying to cripple his championship. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
They tried to sell him away. They tried to throw him into the pit. But they didn't succeed. Because God was with him. God, he saw to it that their crippleness should never work upon his life. I say to you, if ever devil want to cripple your vision, try to cripple your work, try to cripple your marriage, try to cripple your business, it shall not work in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Praise the Nazareth.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hey,
I say,
Niri, if devil
logo Satan
is trying to run after your mission, run after your plan, it is enough. It shall not work. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
The Bible says, this man was born crippled. There are some of the people who are born crippled. Let us look at the issue of Abraham.
Abraham.
The family of Abraham was crippled by generational inheritance. Generational inheritance of delay.
Abraham
was delayed to get a child up to the years of 100. And when we come to his son Isaac, he was married at the age of
40.
But he was delayed for 20 years until he get a child at the age of
60.
We come to the issue of Jacob, the grandson of Abraham. His wife Rachel was delayed to get a child. This generation was born crippled with the spirit of delay. Now I want to pray for you right now. If there was a spirit of delay, generational inheritance of delay upon your life, I say enough is enough. I destroy that crippleness of delay. No more delay in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, the delay of your job is over. The delay of your businesses is over. The delays of your finances is enough. The delays of your fruits of your womb is enough. The delays of your promotions are enough. Enough is enough. In the name of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus Christ, I break that generational spirit of delay. I destroy that generational inheritance of delay. I say no more delay upon your life. Whatever you couldn't do in 30 years, in 40 years, in 50 years, in 70 years, it's never too late. It shall be done today. No more spirit of delay. In Jesus' mighty name. The Bible says, this man was carried. They carried him to the temple every day. When it comes to the issue of caring, this is the issue of love and acceptance. These people were accepting his situation. They were tolerance to his situation. They were so loving to his situation. They were so caring to his situation. In this life, we must learn to accept one another. We must learn to care for one another. We must learn to love one another. We must learn to carry each other's weakness. Wherever I'm weak in the area of life, if you are strong, tell me, when your neighbor is weak in another area of life, carry him. When the church is weak in another area of life, carry him. We must care for one another. Let us carry each other through prayer, through love, through assistance, guidance. Let us carry one another in the name of Jesus. I carry you through prayer. I carry your family through prayer. I carry your children through prayer. In the mighty name of Jesus, I say, let it go well with your life. In the name of Jesus, whatever was not going well in your life, I say, enough is enough. In the name of Jesus, every sickness upon your life, upon your children, I say, enough is enough. I pray for you. I carry you. I carry you. And I carry our nation South Africa.
South Africa.
Prayer. In this moment of the pandemic disease. In this moment of the challenges. Even in your moment of unemployment. I carry you through prayer. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Now listen. When it comes to the issue of carrying one another, we must be carried. But there must be another level of maturity. Because everybody has a stage of maturity. There is a social maturity. There is a spiritual and intellectual maturity. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
The Bible says this man was carried every day. But the moment John and Peter arrived, this man was not intellectual. Maturity enough. Because he was failing to understand that way. When he met Peter, he was supposed to choose to be healed than choosing to get money. It is good to have money. But life must come first. Healing must come first. Because when there is life and healing, follow. But this man was not intellectual enough to be able to understand why which one must come first in his life. He was choosing for the money. You know, in life, there must be the time when we are carried. But when we are carried, we must become mature. When you become mature, you will say to the people who carry you, thank you for carrying me to be where I am. Maybe I should not be where I am today. But because you have done mercy to me, I say thank you. But
in
the situation itself, you must speak another language. You must say, I'm carried is enough. Enough is enough. Now, I must learn to toggle. I must learn to walk. I must learn to run. I thank God for those who carried you from your youth, from your unemployment, when you were sick. But the time must come when you must tell them, thank you so much. May God richly bless you. And you must talk to the situation. New situation. Enough is enough. I am carried this enough. It is my time that I must stand and carry others so that when they grow up, they will carry the others. That will become a gently and good circle of life. Oh, hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
The situation of this crippled man depended on the people who carried him. When you are carried forever without the moment of saying enough is enough, you will always depend on the people who carry you. His vision depended on those who carried him. Because they were the one who decided we shouldn't get, put him into the temple, but let him remain at the gate. Your destiny or wherever you are going shall be decided by those who carry you.
La ifanele koko ya fika kona kumbe akale shirandaka ikungwa atala hela vakurwalaka.
Because if you are carried in your decision,
hikuva loko irwaliwa eka makungu ya wena,
if you are always carried in your choices,
loko itshama ikari irwaliwa eka kulanga ka wena,
whatever you need in life
hinkwaswa leswi ishilavaka evutonwini
shall be limited within the will of those who carry you.
Chitapimiwa na kuya helewa hela vakurwalaka masiku hinkwawo.
It shall be limited within the desires of those who carry you.
Chitapimiwa hikuya hikunavela ka lava vakurwalaka.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
And another thing in life,
and xin'wanyana futhi evuton'wini,
when you are always carried,
loko i tshama i ri karhi i rhwaliwa,
you will always work for the benefit of those who carry you.
I ta tirha i karhi i tirhela ku vuyeriwa ka lava kurhwalaka.
Because the Bible says,
hiku bibele yi
ri, this man was begging every day.
N'wanuna loyi a tshama a ri ku kombeleni masiku hinkwawo.
Now if it is every day,
se loko ku ri hi ku i masiku hinkwawo,
when did he get time to spend money?
Nkarhi wa ku va a ya dya mali liya a wu kuma kwihi?
It means those who carried him were the one who was spending the money.
Swi ti komba kahle leswaku lava a va n'wi rhwala hi vona lava a va teka mali liya va ya dya loko a ha tshame le.
I say enough is enough.
Ni ri he swi ringana swi ringane.
The spirit of beggar,
nkarhi moya wa ku kombela.
I say enough is enough.
Swi ringana swi ringane.
The spirit of begging,
moya wa ku kombela.
That was upon this man,
lowu a wu ri henhla ka n'wanuna.
The spirit of begging,
moya wa ku kombela,
which may be upon your life,
lowu nga va ku ehenhla ka vutomi bya n'wina.
I say enough is enough.
Ni ri he swi ringana swi ringane.
If there is a person,
loko ku ri na munhu,
who shall never beg,
loyi a nga ta ka nga kombeli,
it's you.
Hi n'wina.
It's your family.
I ndyangu wa n'wina.
It's your children.
I vana va n'wina.
Because the Lord,
hi ku hosi,
shall supply you.
Yi ta mi phamela.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Hi vito ra matimba ra Yesu.
The Bible says,
bibele yi ri,
this man,
n'wanuna loyi,
seated at the gates,
a tshama enyangweni.
Jesus says,
Yesu aku,
I am the gate.
Hi mina nyangwa.
Jesus is the gate of life.
Yesu Kriste yena nyangwa ya vutomi.
The gate of salvation.
Nyangwa ya ku ponisiwa.
The gate of healing.
Nyangwa ya ku horisiwa.
The gate of delivering.
Nyangwa ya ku ntshuxiwa.
The gate of peace.
Nyangwa ya ku rhula.
If this man was put at the gate,
se loko ku ri hi ku n'wanuna loyi a karhi a vekiwa laha nyangweni,
without entering into the church,
a nga ngheni endzeni ka tempele,
it means that he was staying at the gate of salvation.
Swi vula leswaku a lo tshama kwalaya gedeni ya ku ponisiwa.
At the gate of his blessings,
kwalaya gedeni ya mikateko ya yena.
At the gate of his healing,
kwalaya gedeni ya ku horisiwa ka yena.
At the gate of his deliverance,
kwalaya gedeni ya ku ntshuxiwa ka yena.
Without entering into the blessings,
a nga ngheni endzeni ka
enough is enough.
Swi ringana swi ringana.
If there is a person,
loko ku ri na
munhu, who shall not remain at the gate,
laha nga ta ka a nga tshami a
gedeni, who shall enter into the blessings,
laha nga ta nghena a mikatekeni,
it's you.
Hi n'wina.
In the name of Jesus.
Hi vito ra matimba ra Yesu.
And Peter said,
kutani Petro a ku,
oh gentlemen,
oh vavanuna,
silver and gold,
hina siku na silivhere,
I don't have,
a hina swona,
what I have,
leswi ni nga na swona,
I give you,
na ku nyika,
I say in the name of Jesus,
ni ri hi vito ra Yesu,
stand up and walk,
suka yima yi famba,
what I have I give you,
leswi ni nga na swona na ku nyika,
wherever you are,
kwala mi nga kona,
I give you life,
ni mi nyika vutomi,
in the name of Jesus,
hi vito ra matimba ra Yesu,
I give you healing,
ni mi nyika ku horisiwa,
in the name of Jesus,
hi vito ra matimba ra Yesu,
I give you protection,
ni mi nyika ku hlayiseka,
in the name of Jesus,
hi vito ra matimba ra Yesu,
I give you peace,
ni mi nyika ku rhula,
in the name of Jesus,
hi vito ra matimba ra Yesu.
Simon held him,
Simon a n'wi khoma,
the Bible says,
a n'wi pfuna,
the man was healed,
n'wanuna a horisiwa,
instantly,
kan'we kan'we,
upon your life,
ehenhla ka vutomi bya n'wina,
I prophesy instant miracle,
ni profeta singitara ku humelela kan'we kan'we,
instant breakthrough,
ni profeta singitara ku mi boxeketa eka swilo sweswi,
if you cannot see,
loko ku ri hi ku a mi voni,
with your eyes,
matihlo ya n'wina,
instantly let the Lord open your eyes,
kan'we kan'we Xikwembu a xi pfule matihlo ya lama,
instantly begin to walk right now,
kan'we kan'we sungula ni ku famba kwala mi nga kona sweswi,
the Bible says,
bibele yi ri,
the man jumped up, started walking and leaping,
n'wansati n'wanuna loyi a suka a yima a tlela henhla a sungula ku famba a karhi a tlulatlula,
praising the Lord,
a karhi a dunisa hosi,
for you to receive your miracle,
ku va n'wina mi kuma singita ra n'wina,
is for your purpose to praise the Lord.
I xikongomelo xa leswaku n'wina mi ta dunisa hosi,
so that the name of the Lord shall be glorified,
leswaku vito ra
The Bible says the man started to follow Peter. Every good thing the Lord do to your life, He do it for the purpose that you should follow Him. He do it for the purpose that you shall become His disciple. He do it for the purpose that you should remain in Him. Everything which the Lord has done in your life, and whatever the Lord shall still do in your life, He do it for the purpose that you should remain in Him. He do it for the purpose that you shall become His child. He do it for the purpose that you should follow Him. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
May the Lord richly bless you. Stay blessed.
Amen.